Welcome to Tomahawk Talk. I'm your host, Daniela. Each week, Tomahawk Talk gives you a behind-the-scenes look at the Kings County Chiefs Youth Football Club, complete with interviews with the players and coaches, and highlights and weekly fitness tips from celebrity fitness trainer Mark Jenkins and his famous Mark Jenkins method. The Chiefs are the only organization in the country that allows kids to play travel league tackle football for free. If you would like to learn more about the Chiefs, donate, or even register to try out for the Chiefs, you can visit us at www.kingscountychiefs.com. You can also email us questions that you'd like answered on the show. This week on Tomahawk Talk, the Chiefs faced Brooklyn Skyhawks this past weekend. We have all the highlights. We talked to some of our Chiefs about the game. And as always, celebrity fitness trainer Mark Jenkins is here with some Chiefs fitness. All on this week's Tomahawk Talk.
I'm Leon, running back for the Kings County Chiefs, and you're watching Tomahawk Talk, Kings County Chiefs Weekly.
Welcome back to Tomahawk Talk, Kings County Chiefs Weekly. Before getting into this past week's game against the Skyhawks, we'd like to recap the Chiefs' 24-6 victory over the Pipples in Week 1. Prior to the game, the Chiefs honored one of our fallen parents, Tony Jackson, the mother of linebacker Fahim Clark, with an honorary coin toss by her family. Now to the game. The Chiefs looked good against the Pitbulls on the first play from scrimmage in Kings County Chiefs Youth Football Club history. Running back Leon took the handoff 70 yards for a touchdown, making Chiefs history. The run set the tone for the game, and the Chiefs never looked back. On the Chiefs' next position, quarterback Jaden took control, completing 11 of 14 passes for 182 yards and rushing for 48 yards. Jaden passed for 2 touchdowns and ran for another. Wide receiver Sammy had a big day, as he hauled in 4 catches for 94 yards with 2 touchdowns. Artie and Jada both added multiple receptions. The Chiefs' offense collectively rushed for 192 yards, led by running back Leon, who recorded 4 carries for 100 yards and contributed 132 total yards with 1 touchdown. The Chiefs' offense line was extraordinary, as the offense gained an impressive 374 yards in their 24-6 victory over the Pipples. The Chiefs were just as impressive on defense, as defensive end linebacker Artie led all defense players with 6 tackles, followed by linebacker Fahim with 4 tackles. Zenobi contributed another 3 tackles from the middle linebacker position, and Sammy and Jada both had fumble recoveries to help spark the Chiefs' win. The Pitbulls scored on a kick return. The Chiefs' coaching staff insisted that mistake would be corrected in Week 2. Other than the kick return for a touchdown, the Chiefs' coaching staff was optimistic after beginning the season with a win, commenting the great thing about this group of kids is that each week there will be a different star and they truly play as a team. In recap, the Chiefs defeat the Pitbulls 24-6 and are 1-0 in league play. Coming off their Week 1 defeat of the Pitbulls, the Chiefs faced a very tough Brooklyn Skyhawks team. The Chiefs expected this to be their toughest game of the season. The Skyhawks came to play. After being down 18-12 at halftime, the Chiefs shocked the New York City youth football community with a dramatic 38-18 comeback win over the historic Brooklyn Skyhawks at home this past Saturday. After going in at halftime down 18-12, the Chiefs turned it on, scoring 26 unanswered points in the second half against the tough Skyhawks team. On the offensive side of the ball, the Chiefs' comeback was led by running back Leon, who contributed a whopping 9 carries for 152 yards with 3 touchdowns. His effort was closely followed by starring quarterback Jaden, who recorded 11 carries for 133 yards and 2 touchdowns before leaving the game with any injury. Backup quarterback Artie entered the game in the third quarter, and his calm and cool demeanor led the team seamlessly down the field. On 3 scoring drives, Artie added a couple of 2-point conversions to seal the deal. Wide receiver Sammy led receivers with 3 receptions for 38 yards. Defensively, the Chiefs were stellar. Defensive tackle Carmine anchored the defense and led all with 12 tackles and a fumble recovery. Chiefs linebacker Zenobi recorded 10 tackles while Josiah and Sammy contributed 7 tackles each. Sammy and Leon both added 1 sack. Now let's take a look at those highlights and interviews.
Brooklyn Skyhawks. Let's go, run out there. There they go. Big hand for the Brooklyn Skyhawks.
Running with reckless abandon is a hallmark of this year's Kings County Chiefs. If they weren't getting it done by the quarterback, Jaden, they were getting it done on the ground by their all-star running back, Leon. But either way, the outcome was still the same. The Kings County Chiefs ended up in the end zone. Dropping right, throwing left, and finding his favorite target, Sammy. This was a very common combination with the Kings County Chiefs. But getting it done on offense wasn't their only way of victory this year. Doing it on defense sometimes proved to be a challenge. But one thing you can't say about the Chiefs, getting into the end zone wasn't going to be easy if they had anything to say about it. Getting a yard here, getting a yard there, might be the only way you could possibly see the end zone. But at the end of the day, they were going to stop it. It was just a matter of time. Stopped. And if Jaden wasn't throwing the ball to his favorite target, Sammy, he was getting it done with his feet as well. Rolling to his left, Jaden often found daylight around the end of the corner as he made it into the end zone. And once again, if you can't find a target, make one. But sometimes, getting into the end zone would prove tough. So if you couldn't do it yourself, why not dial up Sammy? Bringing it to the right, Jaden would call his own number multiple times this particular game. Whatever he needed to do to help the team win. Jukes left, stop for a loss. Sometimes calling your own number can be a good thing, but sometimes it had painful consequences. With a lesser trained team, this could be a problem, but with the Kings County Chiefs, if one man goes down, you simply reload. Handing it off to their favorite running back, Leon, he made sure finding the end zone wasn't going to be a problem, no matter who was quarterbacking the team. And if it wasn't Jaden, Artie was more than capable of stepping in and making it happen. And the Kings County Chiefs machine kept right on rolling, all the way to the end zone. Running right, running left, handing it off, or keeping it yourself. The Kings County Chiefs found a way to get into the end zone. Always elusive and always seemingly getting into the end zone, Leon proved to be unstoppable that day. Already calling his own number and into the end zone. But if you think they're one-dimensional, think again. The Kings County Chiefs' defense was just as dominant. And they came to play. Stopping play after play after play. The defense proved well-coached and well-disciplined. The Chiefs were pretty stellar on defense. The defensive tackle Carmine, who typically anchors the defense, led all with 12 tackles, including a fumble recovery. And the Chiefs linebacker Zenobi, who also recorded 10 tackles, helped alongside Josiah and Sammy. Simply bruising and dominating. You weren't getting the ball in on these guys, not today. And they just simply kept finding ways to stop the ball. It didn't matter which direction you ran, right, left, it was going to be three and out. But not only did they get it done with offense and defense, the special teams also showed that they too could contribute to the game's success. Setting the offense up with great field position, they were able to keep the offense on the field and continue to dominate. Ball Hawks. Getting to the ball and making plays. That was the hallmark of this team this year. And just when it seemed like they had no idea what was going on, they showed you that they were always aware and ever present. Because good defenses make great plays. And that's what the Kings County Chiefs did. not only were they a well-coached, well-disciplined team, but the commitment to excellence, the commitment to each other, and the commitment to passion has allowed the team to see the kind of success early in the season at 2-0.
When you win a game like this, it shows character. All right? It shows heart. It shows that no matter what, you don't quit. We are so proud of you guys.
That's comeback of the year.
Next week, they're on the road against the Bronx Knights and hope to continue their winning ways.
Hey, it's Daniela here. I'm here with Artie, our wide receiver on the Chiefs. Now, Artie, what did you do today?
After the second quarter, I came back in as a backup quarterback, and I won the game. Well, my team won the game.
Today. Really nice. Great. Now, I heard you were in the hospital. Can you tell me about that?
Well, a couple of days ago, I hurt my ear, and then I got an ear infection. So then I had to go to the hospital, and it was a long wait. So I got home by 3 a.m.
And you still made it to the game today?
Yes.
Thank you so much.
Welcome.
Hey, I'm here with Zenobi. Now, Zenobi, what position are you on the team?
I play linebacker and left and right guard.
And what did you do today during the game?
Well, today in the first half, I wasn't doing so good, but when we came out from halftime, I started getting more tackles and playing more aggressive.
Cool. Now, how do you feel about beating the Skyhawks today?
I feel good.
You feel good? Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Hey, I'm here with Leon, the running back on the Chiefs. Now, Leon, what did you do today during the game?
Well, the first quarter, we weren't doing so well, and our quarterback got injured. But in the second quarter, Artie, he took our quarterback spot, and he filled in for great. And so I didn't want to lose, so I thought I had to take it in my hands and get a touchdown. So I got three or four touchdowns, and the score was 38-18.
Really? That's really good. And you guys got 38, right? Because you won.
Yes.
Great. Now, I heard that your first quarterback got injured. How did that happen?
Because we weren't blocking that well in the first half. So, we just got mad. So we had to, get aggressive. So we thought we needed to win this game for him. So in the second half, we did that. We pulled it off against the best team in the league, and now we are.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And I got injured, and I had to sit out the rest of the game. And Artie came through, and he made us win the game. And the offensive line, I have to say, they did good, really good at the end of the game, and the defense too. And Leon, he got three touchdowns. And today I got two touchdowns, full touchdowns, and a 2-point conversion.
Hey, I'm here with Sammy, the receiver and defensive line. Defensive end? Yeah, defensive end on the Chiefs. Now, what did you do today?
I got a couple of sacks, a 2-point conversion, and blocked anybody that came my way.
Now, I heard your quarterback got injured. Now, how did Artie step up as a quarterback? How did he do?
He did amazing. He came up. He gave Leon a couple of touchdowns. He had a touchdown himself and stepped up to the game. Gave us a great game.
Great. Thank you. Now, I heard you guys beat the so-called best team in the league. Now, you guys are the best. Hi, I'm here with Josiah, the D tackle on the Chiefs. Now, Josiah, what did you do today?
In the first half, I wasn't really good, but in the second half, I came out and I started blocking our offense, and I started tackling and making a few tackles and making big stops. And when Artie came in the game, I was surprised because I didn't know what happened to Jaden. So we had to block for Artie because if we lose another quarterback, we have nobody to play quarterback on the team.
So you all chipped in to help Artie stay in the game?
Yes.
Great, thank you. Thomas, what happened today?
Well, we versed the Skyhawks, and in the first half of the game, we were letting Jaden get killed, but in the second half, he got completely sacked, so he hurt his knee, and he got injured, and so Artie stepped in as QB, and we won the game.
Cool. Now, how do you feel after playing as such a good team today?
Well, I think we could do better if, like, everyone attends the practices we do. That way we could be more bigger. That way we could be stronger, and the wide receivers and running backs could run faster and catch the wide receivers can catch the ball.
Great. Now, I guess you guys won today, so you're doing pretty well, right?
Yep.
All right, thank you so much.
Welcome.
Hi, I'm Alex here with Carmine. So, Carmine, what did you do today?
Well, today I had a really good game with all my teammates. We did a lot of blocks on offense. We had a lot of tackles on defense. And I think we just did really good today.
What did you think about the Skyhawks?
Well, the Skyhawks, they had a really good offense. And the quarterback was a really fast runner. He made about 2 touchdowns, and I think they're really good today.
How do you feel about being the number one team?
I think that's amazing because we work so hard at practice and everything, and I think that's just phenomenal.
Thank you for your time.
I am now joined by our field correspondent, Alex. How's it going, Alex?
Great, Daniela. Being on the field with the team, I really get a chance to see the energy of the team. And I must say, this is a very fired up group. They go into every game feeling like they have a chance to win. I'm really looking forward to the rest of the season.
Alex will be joining us each week on the show for the rest of the season. Great game, Chiefs. You're looking good.
That they are. Now it's time, again, for our celebrity fitness super trainer, Mark Jenkins, for some Chiefs fitness training. Let's go, Mark!
Woo!
New York, Rockaway Beach, Kings County Chiefs, celeb trainer Mark Jenkins, Diddy, D'Angelo, Beyonce, Calvin Klein, the list goes on. But I'm most excited to be here with the Chiefs today, and we're gonna rock on the beach. I had so much of a good time last time. I wanna keep it going. Love the beach, low impact, fresh air, water. We're getting it on. All right, as promised, I got 2 super tough guys impervious to pain. Giovanni and Corey, they're going in with me today. You guys watching, 3 sets of 10 each exercise. Only stop to stretch, get a sip of water, keep attacking. You guys right here, if you throw up, don't wipe your mouth until you finish the set. You ready? First exercise. Here we go. What's number 1, guys? Burpee into the plyometric jump. We're gonna take it all the way down to a squat. We're gonna pop out. Push up. Come back in. Jump up. 10 times. You ready? Go. Down. Out. In. Jump. 1. Little speed, little speed. Come on. 2. Go. 3. Go. 4. Go. 5, go. 6, go. These guys are all day. 7, go. 8, go. 9, go. And 10. Nice work, nice work. Breathe. Only enough time to catch their breath, get a sip of water, because you want to work the heart as well as the muscles. So we're keeping that leg attack going. You guys are going to put your hands on your hips. You're going to jump out into a lunge, right leg in front, and you're going to explode up. Switch legs. 2, keep the head up. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 2, 1. Now, 3 sets of 10 each exercise. So you should be at 6 sets right now. And we're gonna go for our last exercise. What is it? Handstand push-up. You're gonna pop a handstand up. Make sure you catch the legs. Give it to me. Up. You're gonna catch the legs. Give me 10. 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6, 7, go, 8, 9, hold the lockout, and then push down so you get a safe landing. Corey, get some pain. Hit it. Oh, hit it.
Go 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
And you can help pull them up if they get stuck a little bit. 2 to go.
1, hold a lockout. Hold, push down. Nice, guys. Excellent push. Excellent push. Can I get a Chiefs all day on 3? 1, 2, 3.
Chiefs all day.
Yeah. Yeah.
Flash the cameraman told me not to move too much, so I want to keep it tight. Thank you so much for watching another action-packed episode of Chiefs Training. Come back, join us. If you're on the beach, make sure you stay hydrated as you're working out. Make sure you stretch after. Train safe. Have fun. Chiefs all day. Yeah.
That's the Mark Jenkins method. We love you, Mark. Thank you for keeping us fit. That's our show for this week. We hope you had a good time. Tomahawk Talk and the Kings County Chiefs would like to thank Charles Phillips and the Infor Corporation for all their support in making this organization possible. We would all also like to thank Shut Sports, Douglas Pads, Gatorade, Dick's Sporting Goods, Good Sports, Boss Containers, Espro Sports Cleaners, Heavy Equipment, Big Apple Props, and Red Zone Reconditioning for all their support in helping the Kings County Chiefs accomplish their mission to provide an environment for kids to play for free, as it should be. Remember to visit us online at www.kingscountychiefs.com and to friend us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter as KC Chiefs Kids. We'll see you right back here next week on Tomahawk Talk. And remember, do the tomahawk chop, go.
Do the tomahawk chop. One time for the boy, little Artie. 24, 2 times for my dog, Jada. JG. One time for my homeboy, Sal. Little Sal. 2 times for my dog, Carlo. Number 11. One time for the homie, Chinzo. Vinny D. 2 times for Luciano. Big Luch. 1 time for my dog, Little Flash. Flash on. 2 times for Carmelo. Mellow Man. Do the tomahawk chop. Go. Go. Do the tomahawk chop. Chiefs. Do the tomahawk chop. Go. Go. Do the tomahawk chop. Chiefs. 1 time for the boy, Fahim Clark. Little Junior. 2 times for my dog, Abraham. One time for Kata QB, gon' throw it. 2 times for my dog Sammy, going long. 1 time for my dude Leon, Big L. 2 times for the homie Carmine, 28. 1 time for the Kings County Chiefs, KC. 2 times for this healthy hip hop.